friends, welcome back to this React.js advanced concept series. In the last video, I explained error boundary in React. In this video, I'll be talking about code splitting and lazy loading in React. Let's get started. Code splitting and lazy loading are two powerful techniques that help improve the performance of React applications. Instead of loading all the JavaScript at once, we can load parts of our app only when they are needed. This helps reduce the initial loading time, resulting in faster page loads and a smoother user experience. Now let's see what code splitting is. Code splitting means breaking your app's code into smaller pieces or chunks. This way, the browser doesn't have to download everything right away. It just loads the code required for the page the user is currently viewing. As users move around the app, React loads the remaining code on demand. Let me explain this using a simple example. I have created this application. Here I have few navigation links. Using them, I can navigate to different pages. Right now, I haven't added any code splitting. If I open the network tab and refresh the home page, you will see a big JavaScript file of around 445 KB gets downloaded. This is the JavaScript bundle of the entire application. And so, if I navigate to any other pages, we can see no new chunk has been downloaded. Now let's say in the products page, I add the Lodash library, which is pretty large. After adding it, when I refresh the home page again, the bundle size increases to around 541 KB. Even though we used Lodash only on the products page, it's being loaded with the main bundle. That's not ideal. This becomes an even bigger problem in large applications where many libraries or components are not needed immediately. In this scenario, we can use code splitting. Let me show you how we can do that. First, let me create a separate file and move this Lodash related code here. I need to export this from here. And then in the product component, I can import this function dynamically. Like this. Now when I refresh the home page, the bundle is back to around 445 KB. The Lodash code isn't loaded yet. But when I visit the products page, and click the button that uses Lodash, only then the extra code is downloaded. This way we can achieve code splitting to improve the initial page load. Hope you understood about code splitting. Okay, let me explain about lazy loading. Lazy loading is a similar concept. It means loading parts of your app like components only when they are needed. Okay, let me explain this using the same example. We have seen how we can dynamically import the helper function and achieve code splitting. Let me modify that. Instead of dynamically loading this, let me import this normally. Now, if I refresh the home page, we can see again the bundle size has been increased. Here, if you see, this function has been used only in the product component. But even though it is not used in the home component, this is getting loaded as part of the main bundle. To solve this, we can use lazy loading. Let me show you how we can implement lazy loading. First, instead of importing these components directly, let us use lazy function from React. Like this. Here we have another function which returns the import dynamically. Let me do this for other imports also. Okay, now we need to do one more thing. We need to wrap all these routes inside suspense component. Only then it will work. Suspense is required when we use React lazy to handle code split components. Without suspense, React won't know what to show while the lazy component is being downloaded and rendered. For that, in the suspense component, we can mention a fallback UI. Like this. Now let's see. If I refresh the home page, the main bundle and a small chunk of around 1.4 KB for the home page are loaded. When I navigate to the about page, React loads another small chunk for about. When I visit the product page, now the Lodash code of around 97 KB is only loaded at that time. In case, if I go back to any other pages, we can see no further JavaScript bundles or chunks will be downloaded because those are already downloaded in the browser. If I go to contacts page, we can see a new small chunk for contact page has been downloaded now. So this is how lazy loading loads only parts of the application when they are needed. Okay, before we close, let me also show you the use of suspense. By default, you may not always see the fallback content because the component loads too quickly. Let me add some code to delay loading this contact component. So now if I refresh, we can see the initial bundle has been loaded and it is waiting for 3 seconds for the contact chunk to get loaded. In the meantime, we can see the fallback UI in the screen. So we can make use of this to show some spinner. Hope you understood about lazy loading also. That's all for today. I hope you now understand the importance of code splitting and lazy loading in React. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and leave a comment with your questions or topic suggestions. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.